This is number 3 for today. Oh, there's CCPD over there. There's one right next to me driving down too. I'd let him get in front of me instead of behind me. So this is a beautiful spot. You see me make a lot of videos out here. The main police station is right over here, which is one of the biggest expenses you have. Salaries for public service is one of the biggest expenses. Now this would have been a good I got a few teaching videos to do. So today, oftentimes now you have the bicycle cops. You see them here quite often up and down the strip. And you already know the salaries that you pay. They basically spend time telling other people, watch out for John, he carries a gun, watch out for Mr. Pope, he's dangerous. They go around, that's part of their daily routine. You had a shooting right here, as a matter of fact, maybe about 2 months ago, but there was somebody shooting that he was, I think they shot him. I mentioned that case simply because it was right by the police station, and there was a female officer, which is fine, but I believe one of them was a rookie. And they didn't even have, with all of the senior guys, when you have a shooting, the guy was shooting right here at cars. Chief Markle, look, obviously they shot that kid. I don't know if he died, but said they did a good job. Question would have been, I mentioned that before, why didn't you send some senior officers? Do they not respond? Or do they just choke? Citizens at parties? Do they just assault my friends at Stripes? And after it's all known to your leadership, you promote them, you just keep rolling along. Now, the amount of the cost for this department in Corpus Christi, Texas, just I've not looked it up, I know. It's, along with the fire department, it's the biggest expense for the entire city. And when they're caught in wrongdoing, you just noticed, even with the Toomey case, they just pay. They pay out money, but there's zero accountability. You have officers on the job that have committed felonies, known by the leadership of the department. In the case of my friend that was assaulted, beat up, put in the hospital, like the picture of Mr. Toomey. The only thing is, the only reason he was targeted was because the cop was mad because he didn't find drugs on him. And then he went and changed into civilian clothes and then assaulted and put him in the hospital. They didn't know it was that officer. He's promoted. He's leadership in this department of Corpus Christi, Texas. So these are felony crimes committed. The only reason they do not have records is because they commit crimes and they're not going to arrest each other. That's the only reason they don't have records. So is beautiful as you see Corpus Christi, the Bayfront. It's beautiful as you, oh, there's a homeless brother there. I don't know. But that's a huge problem. You know, the new DA with the district attorney's office is actually up the street. The church will probably, I'll try and walk that way. That's, I'm going to go to that church Sunday, the cathedral. DA, Mark Gonzalez, he had the Bishop Mulvey bless the DA office. And it was fine, and it came out in the Corpus paper, but they said it never happened before. But then it was very interesting, Bishop Mulvey, and they explained that the foundation of law actually comes from Scripture, the Old Testament. But I found it interesting. And they were it showed the picture in the Corpus paper, they were praying. Because of the corruption, they felt they had to purge it. And of course, they got a new DA, who's Mark Gonzalez now. Mark Skirk is gone. And everyone in the local media, I've read many stories and seen a lot, they all knew there was tremendous corruption in that office. Many, the former DA was brought before Judge Nanette Hassett, and many stories made public, Hanover, Tinnenholm. But the police department, they never cleaned out the corruption in that. That's the problem. The police department is right down there. City Hall's over there. I would cross, but I don't see the crosswalk, so, you know, they might shoot you for jaywalking. They've never cleaned up the crosswalks. Just the fact that Captain Cook, you know, if you're not choking citizens, you're going to trial. And then you hear nothing else about the citizen that was choked in front of many witnesses. Zero. Zero accountability. This is known that some officers have committed many multiple felonies in the city. I've reported on Xanax on my friends. Acknowledged, admitted, yes, we planted Xanax. Apologized for it in front of many witnesses. And they all know about it. Well, don't commit felonies again. Promise you're not going to commit no more felonies. Just write up the ranks. So now, for those of them simply concerned with the PD vehicle, those who are simply concerned with the money, when they redid this downtown, it was pretty much a debacle with the city leadership and council. They allowed the whole downtown to be rerouted. And it used to be this road, beautiful Ocean Drive, or Shoreline, you used to drive it straight all the way along the water turn. And they rerouted it. It goes, kind of cuts down. Municipalities do that to try to get business into the downtown. Our downtown is a nice downtown, but it lacks business because the south side, growth of the city went to the south side. Kingsville, I read an article the other day doing the same thing. They're trying to revitalize downtown. But the cost, when you spend the amount of money for the salaries for CCPD, it's imperative that, first of all, crimes are not committed by you, which have been acknowledged, understood. It's no secret, they all know it. The case, like I said, they come public in the paper, and when settlements are made, but this, they got away with felonies, assault. I know the public is not really aware, and maybe some of the officers, I'm sure there are good cops. The problem is with the leadership of the department. Chief Markle, he lives where I live in Flower Bluff. Now, this is the other side of Corpus Christi. This is downtown. Pretty day. But Chief Markle lives right by my friend's house, actually. And he has the supervision. He just needs to retire. And you have to get an outside chief. Someone like Mr. Simpson, who we had. That's the only way you're going to deal with it. You know, you'll have, I'm sure cops are still telling people today, well, John Stangers is carrying a gun. When you spread rumors like that, I reported that. Got no answer. I told Markle, look, I want to know, why do you have no answer? Nah, we don't answer the phone. We do what we want. This, okay, the main cop shop is down there. I really don't want to walk to it only because these are not my regular teaching videos, so I don't want to go to it. But I want you to get a feel of, you said, what set you off? Look, you guys have been approaching me. I went to New Jersey for 3 weeks, New York City area. You all saw the videos, my friends. Since I've been back, I don't know how many times you guys have come up. And it's just not normal. You say, but look, I'm not drinking, I'm not doing that. Wherever I'm at, if you guys have come up to me and had many questions for me, pretending like you don't know. Do you know the officer yesterday? You know, it's a crime to lie to the cops. They can arrest you for lying to a cop. Of course, I don't lie. But do you know the questions was, what year did you retire from the fire department? Now, I retired in 2008, but do you know if I said 2009 and got it off, I could be arrested for that. I found it interesting. He said, and when did you move to Corpus Christi? And I gave him the year of 1992. And many detailed questions. Sort of like a list of things. And what is 2 and 2? What is 4? What is 53 times 19? Oh, you lied, brother. You know, we're strict in the city. And lying is, that's, you understand? The year you retired, and when did you start the ministry? Just like a laundry list. And they know. And where do you live? They know where I live. What is the exact address? You know the address. It was like a question and answer sheet to, it's wrong, the lot of cop. Okay, John, explain to us the cosmology of Ptolemy. Oh, I'll give you the cosmology of Ptolemy, and Ptolemy developed, I told all this before, actually. Ptolemy developed ancient cosmology at the time of Plato and Aristotle. He was one of the four generals of Alexander. Kingdom broke up, and what, John, with the two other generals, I forget the names, Seleucid Kingdom, oh, you got that man under arrest, brother. You can't be lying to us. Yeah, but you're asking me a very detailed question. We're very strict in this city. The only people allowed to commit felonies openly and in public and crimes are CCPD. And the way we resolve the felonies committed by our officers is we promote them. And so how much, Corpus Christi, Texas, are the salaries of these guys? It's equal to the fire department and cops. I've not seen a whole lot of things. You said, John, but there's not a whole lot of reports in Corpus Christi of people that were shot. And there was a disabled kid you shot. I'm sure the parents have a question about that. That was a few years ago. You ran a guy over on Agnes Street at night. And you were not going to an emergency room. And odds are you were speeding, because we used to have problems with that at the fire department. Not problems, but if you're in an emergency vehicle, by law, you can only go a certain amount of the speed limit. But cops have a tendency at times to, you know, they're not going on an emergency run. And there was this a few years ago, there was Agnes or Leopard. I think it was a black man. You ran that man over. There was no investigation. You were I'm sure you didn't see him. It was at night. You were not going code 3 or in emergency mode. There was zero accountability. I'm not sure if that man died. And all the papers and media reported on that case was the officer was real shooken up about it. When you shot that disabled kid a few years ago, I think that was Cal Allen, the mother called the police, her son, younger kid, mental disability or something. And he was shot, and then he was charged with, he was in the hospital. The reason you don't hear a lot of those cases is they're covered up here, whether they're questionable cases. Oh, there's my friends. Just sitting there. CCPD. How much does it cost for them? Oh, he's turning around. Yeah, can't have John out here. This is another public. Oh, there's another one. It's beautiful. Two of them, and this one turned around. There's the other one right there pulling up. Oh, you can't see me. He's behind the Selena statue. Maybe you'll see him when I walk by. There's one right across the street there. Yeah, you can't be out in public walking, videoing. That other one just went. Yes, just when citizens are in public paying your salaries, don't be approaching those citizens without cause. You have no need to be telling my friends in the street, who according to you yesterday told me are very dangerous, and then you tell those same friends a few months ago, John's very dangerous because John carries a gun and you got to watch out for John. So you're telling people that you yourselves deem as dangerous because you reported that to me, and then those same people, you're saying, watch out for John, he has a gun on him. All I can imagine is you're trying to incite violence. Besides the fact that you're not supposed to be doing it. That's assuming a statue right there. Well, the chief should get his retirement and just, you know, do his retirement and try to hold some of these guys accountable. Try to hold, what we want to know is what undisclosed location did you take Mr. Toomey to? What we want to know is the recordings of the five phone calls that he made. I'm assuming he called 911. And what we want to know is why you told him the last time he called before he killed three people at a trailer park, why you told him not to call again or we'll arrest you. And then when you found out that there was a shooting, you were so pissed off because he did, others had to call. There's been a shooting. That was your anger. It wasn't, you fluffed it off to the media that your anger was, look at that nice sailboat. That your anger was, obviously were mad because innocent people were killed. That wasn't your anger. Your anger was, he was calling you that day trying to get you to come. And you were determined not to do your job that day. And then finally, you had to respond. That was your anger. The crime was you brought him to an undisclosed location and assaulted him. And the discipline by Chief Markle and you guys was zilch. Simpson fired too, but Markle should have investigated and found out what undisclosed. What undisclosed location does CCPD use to bring people to assault them? So this is, look how pretty that is. Oh, sanctuary. I like that. It says that there. Many, I could quote, but then I have to make teaching video. So that's it. This is number three for today. Why did an officer yesterday, the witness is Shannon Case. Go ask that witness today, Mr. Detectives. I know you're not busy because you don't respond to 911 calls. I know you're not busy because there was about 10 cop cars in front of the cop shop. And there was supposedly no officer in the building. So, ask Mr. Case. I have the question also asked of Clara K. Elliott. Other detectives, not the criminals, others, ask them why you spread rumors about John Chiarello, that he's carrying a gun, and you put those rumors on the street to other friends who you also say are very dangerous. That's the question of Chief Markle. Maybe before your retirement, you could resolve some of that. I know the money for your salary is going to keep going, and I know you have no intention of changing. And I know, according to you, I'm breaking the law now, because you gave me notice not to be in public at that park. You gave me notice not to be seen in the parking lot of Rock City Church, which owns half their parking lot. I'm surprised I haven't seen any bicycle cops today. So that's the question. So be number three, Chief. I'd like to have the answer for that officer yesterday. Maybe you can talk to him and say, don't go around telling people that James Pope is a dangerous criminal. Oh, there they go. They're your friends. You see them? Especially people that you then say about me that I'm a dangerous gun toter, which also is a lie. At least you got my friends at the end. This is number three.